I bring her home, she ratchet. The bitty bitch, you know she nasty. I'm putting Chanel on her back. Alright, what's good YouTube? And welcome to another video of Put You On Game. And in today's video, we're actually going to be speaking about the real reason as to why OnlyFans has put a ban in the explicit videos being uploaded on their website. Just to kind of put into context, I want you to think about YouTube, for an example. The platform YouTube isn't a platform where you're going to be seeing a lot of inappropriate stuff. The reason why is because YouTube is trying to cater to the mass audience. That's children, working class people, parents, and just anyone that wishes to be entertained. So when it comes to sexual stuff, you wouldn't really be seeing that on YouTube, because YouTube is trying to be put everywhere because they're trying to get more deals and more endorsements, and the advertisement money will be higher because a lot of businesses will know that YouTube is the number one platform where you should promote any upcoming movies, series, or any new services or product that you're going to be launching. They know that the number one place that's going to get a lot of eyeballs is YouTube. Why? Because of the user-friendly website that it has given to people, allowing them to just jump on it freely without feeling conscious or looking around at, oh, you know, I don't want people knowing that I'm on YouTube. So just that type of freedom that YouTube gives, it allows a lot of money to come in. OnlyFans have realized that there's a cap in the market when it comes to only becoming successful through allowing people to upload sexual videos onto their platform. So that's why OnlyFans, number one, is steering away from that, because in order to take that website to a greater height and to compete with someone like YouTube, you're gonna have to change the look and the perception that your website has. So let me actually get into the whole reason as to why OnlyFans is ditching the whole porn concept being uploaded onto their website. So I want to read you this article that was actually published by BBC, so you can have an understanding of where OnlyFans is coming from. This article, it literally says, OnlyFans said the change had come after pressure from banking partners. The site has grown during the pandemic and says it has 130 million users. In order to ensure the long-term sustainability of our platform and continue to host an inclusive community of creators and fans, we must evolve our content guidelines. One of the key words in that statement is long-term and sustainability. Now, speaking of long-term, there's a lot of people that always resort to creating an OnlyFans account out of desperation. Whether they've been laid off from their job, or whether they're short on money, or whether they're looking for a career change but they don't know where to go, or they're a bit confused. A lot of people just be like, okay, cool, you know what? I'm gonna create an OnlyFans, make a couple hundreds or make a couple thousands, and then boom, I'm gonna leave, and then I'm gonna do what I really wanna do. So that type of short-term thinking, OnlyFans have realized that a lot of people, they come on the platform, upload whatever mess that they upload, and then as soon as they made their money, they're out. And then OnlyFans are the ones that are left to clean up their mess, especially when it comes to sexual stuff, because they OnlyFans don't police their videos as if it's a porn website, because it isn't. They look at their platform as a website where content creators can come and upload any type of appropriate videos, whether you're a cook, an investor, or a teacher. You provided that exclusive video to your fans, that's what OnlyFans is about. OnlyFans is not a porn website. So that's why OnlyFans doesn't police the videos that gets uploaded onto their site. Now, OnlyFans have realized that a lot of people are uploading these sexual videos and they don't even know if they're of age to be in those type of videos. Or they don't even know if those videos being uploaded is revenge porn. They don't know that that video being uploaded is coming from a sex trafficking ring that's been, you know, violating men and women and uploading them on OnlyFans. Now, just to kind of give you a difference between OnlyFans and a difference between videos being uploaded on Pornhub, for you to even upload your video on Pornhub with someone else, you will need to sign a age performer release. You will need to sign an affidavit. You will also need to sign a user policy. And then we need to sign a consensual document that says, yes, I give consent for this video on my behalf to be uploaded onto so-and-so's platform on Pornhub. That's why Pornhub is able to solicit and police their videos, because they actually are very attentive when it comes to those type of videos being uploaded
because they're actually a porn website. So they're trying to stick to the guidelines. Now, also as well, in an article, Pornhub have actually removed every single video that's on their platform that doesn't come from a verified user. So Pornhub have already noticed that they don't want any allegations or going to court in the future in terms of any type of videos that have been uploaded out of sex trafficking, revenge porn, or videos out of consent being uploaded on their platform, and then they're the ones that are going to be receiving the stick over it, and they're the ones that are going to be going to court. So that's how they've removed all those videos that are not relating to any verified user on their platform. So now I want to read you the article that OnlyFans have actually put out a statement in terms of, you know, the reason why they're making this change. I'm actually going to go back and read again the article, because there's a very valid point of the reason why they're choosing a new direction. So in the article, it states here, OnlyFans said the change had come after pressure from banking partners. The reason why there's a lot of pressure coming from their bankers is because the revenue that OnlyFans actually made in 2020, they've actually revenued $375 million in net revenue in 2020 and expect $1.2 billion in 2021. Now, out of the hundreds of millions that OnlyFans have made, how many complaints, refunds, chargebacks have OnlyFans received over the years of whilst they were actually earning this type of money going towards their bankers? The amount of complaints and stuff that their bank has received, for an example, people go on OnlyFans and they expect a one-on-one interaction with the content creator, or they expect like a bespoke video being made just for them. So people are spending £200, £300, £500, a grand over exclusive content that's to be provided to them only. And sometimes these people, they don't deliver. Sometimes the men and women don't deliver on the service that they were promised. So what a lot of people do is when they pay £500 for an exclusive video or one-to-one interaction with these influencers or these models, they don't get their promised video. So they call up their bank, and pretty much the bank will probably be Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, or Goldman Sachs, one of those banks, because majority of the audience that have given OnlyFans success come from America. So a lot of these customers are going to call their Bank of America and be like, yo, I know you see that £300, £500, I need you to run that back to me, because I'm dissatisfied with the service or the product that I didn't receive from this person on such and such. And then the bank is going to be thinking, okay, what happened? Why do you want your £500 back? Why do you want us to claim it back for you? And then the more the company digs deeper as to the reason why, then they realize that, oh, so you were on OnlyFans and then you were promised a service and it wasn't delivered. So that's why you want your money back. So out of the hundreds of millions, there's a lot of men and women that have been finessed when they're expecting this exclusive one-on-one interaction or exclusive video coming from the model, and they don't get it. And then they complain to their bank. So then the bank is now having an issue with OnlyFans saying, yo, what's going on? Like, do you guys only do porn over there? Why are we getting so many dissatisfied customers running back to us trying to claim their money back because of a service that wasn't provided to them? So now OnlyFans are going to be receiving a stick from their banks because of the, you know, unprofessionalism that's coming from their website. Well, why they're actually getting pressure from their banks is because, like I said earlier in the video, banks also don't want to get involved in a mess where there's allegations being put onto them from unsolicited consensual videos being uploaded, and Barclays or Bank of America or Halifax had anything to do with that. Because imagine if one day you woke up and you saw in the news Barclays is involved in a huge sex trafficking ring, videos that have been uploaded exclusively onto OnlyFans, and Barclays were the bank that kind of processed those payments. So imagine OnlyFans not knowing that those type of videos were uploaded on their website, and then those payments that people were paying in order to see those type of videos, Barclays were the people that were actually processing those payments. Now Barclays is in court for a huge sex trafficking ring videos that have been uploaded, or Barclays is in court over revenge porn that's been uploaded. That's going to be so messy. So that's one of the reasons why OnlyFans and their banks came to an agreement and said, yo, We appreciate that you guys have this going on and you're making hundreds of millions and it's great. However, we can't be helping you guys out if this is what's being uploaded and you guys are not even policing what's being uploaded on your website. You've been under fire and received a lot of stick from child pornography being uploaded onto their website. So I'm going to read you this article that's had OnlyFans pressured into changing their guidelines. On BBC has literally said, under 18s have used fake identification to set up accounts and police say a 14-year-old used a grandmother's passport. Now imagine you being a huge company that you're looking to compete with YouTube, but then you got these type of allegations and got to court because there's underage kids uploading sexual videos on your platform. How are you going to compete with YouTube when you're being dragged down with these allegations and also as well these lawsuits? So that's why OnlyFans have been changing up their guidelines over time, but it was getting very worse because they still wasn't policing the type of videos that were being uploaded. Now, further in the article, it also says as well, schools have shared anonymous reports of pupils using the site, including a 16-year-old who boasted to her career advisor about the amount of money she made on the site and showed off her exorbitant spending on Instagram. So these are the type of things that OnlyFans are trying to steer away from, because these are videos that are being uploaded without them actually looking into the videos properly. OnlyFans have realized that, you know what, there's a cap in becoming a website that only receives huge revenue from the porn side of it. So that's why they're like, look, we appreciate all the content that you guys uploaded. We appreciate that you guys, you know, have made these type of videos and have blown us up over in the States and also in the UK as well, and have revenued in these hundreds of millions, but it's time for us to put an end to it, because the OnlyFans have realized that, you know what, there's a cap when it comes to this type of niche. So that's why they're putting an end to it and saying, look, we're going to have to change it up, because they're looking to compete with the YouTubes, the Vimeos and stuff like that. But still putting up these type of sexual videos is only going to put a stronghold in terms of where they're looking to take the company. So that's my two cents in the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, stay tuned, because I'm going to be uploading more business news and more entrepreneurial updates. So make sure you stay tuned for the next video.